Hello everyone, today we are going to showcase our own home kitchen and we're going to go in a step-by-step way to figure out why we have put certain hardware and certain designs in this space and how we use it in our own kitchen. Okay, so starting from here, this is a 14 by 14 kitchen that we have over here, and we have left this space from over here, 3 feet space for a fridge, after which we have a pantry followed by a small rolling shutter, inbuilt appliances, and grain trolleys. So over here we guys have an uplift. So as you can see, we guys have used a glass shelf. Generally, we always use a glass shelf for the upper cabinets or for having storage on a much bigger height, because you're able to identify a lot of the storage from beneath the glass shelf also. We guys have the pantry. So as you can see, these are the drawers that are made for internal storage. They are very useful. This is what we generally recommend that people should have to make sure that a lot of storage is being optimized. These are especially useful for storing stuff on the bottom, because generally these are the areas where whatever you store, if you store at the backside, it becomes really hard to access them, specifically if they are going to be heavy objects. So we make sure that these drawers are of high quality. They generally have a 50 kg load bearing capacity. The ones that we've used over here are of Hettich. Then over here we have the rolling shutter. This is quite an old rolling shutter over here. This was, I think, of Hettich. It's been some time. This is actually used over here to conceal the various home appliances. We have the microwave, we have toasters, we have handheld mixers. And over here we have our inbuilt OTG. We have a drawer, a small thin one. And we have a grain trolley. This is again a grain trolley. Is basically used for having big storages of flour, rice, sugar, oils. Heavy storage is generally kept over here. The channels used over here are of Grass Company, and these are generally they have heavy load bearing capacity. So they have a 50 kg load bearing capacity. We have a corner. Over here, the corner that we've used is with a normal wooden shelf only, which goes all the way to the back for maximum storage. As you can see, we generally use it for small containers, plastic containers. And now for this entire area, we guys have the major storage, and the items over here are consistently used in cooking at every point in time. So we guys have the masalas over here. We guys have the flours, moor masalas, chakla belna, the cutleries of all kinds. We have flour, lentil, pastas, sugar. Over here we have our patilas, pots and pans. Same, again we have our pots and pans over here. So as you can see, all these are aligned in a certain way so that most of the masalas, most of the items which you need to use consistently one after the other, they are much more easily accessible, and they are placed on the upper side of the cabinets, and the pots and pans, they are below it. That's why it makes sure that it's designed in a way that your small movements are not the small movements or in the kitchen are not repeated over and over again, because if the pots and pans are up above and the masalas were kept down, it would lead to more movement on a regular basis. So this is how you try to ensure that you have a smart design. In the wall cabinets, we basically have a shelf light over here. This works very well because it makes sure that the inside as well as the bottom of the cabinet is illuminated. It has a great effect when you're doing prep work, as well as it gives a great look on the inside of the cabinet. So over here, we've rightly used our crockeries to be displayed in a very particular way, so that they look good, they look nice, and the light shines through. The same thing is used over here. And now at this side, we have the sink, as well as we have the dish racks. Over here, we have another pantry unit. We don't have, we have not given any drawers in this, but we have given plenty of shelves. This also adds a lot to the storage. Over here also. In this kitchen, we've used a cappuccino acrylic finish, which has been complemented again by the black glass shutters that we have over here. This was a personal choice of my mother, and she really liked it. The handles that we've used is of champagne, which actually goes very well with the cappuccino color in itself. So you can see that the black glass is also used in a way that it goes well with the stone. So do like and subscribe our channel. Hope everybody is safe during this pandemic and they are following the basic government guidelines. If you guys have any more questions and you find this thing helpful, do let us know. We'll be back with more content.